Several crown pathologists believed the large size of the wound was caused by the end of the silencer being placed hard against the skull, ensuring the full force of the gases from the end of the silencer hit the head. Another possible cause of the large entry wound was that an object had been placed between the end of the rifle and the top of the skull when the bullet was fired. This would have slowed the bullet down and caused damage somewhere between a high-energy bullet impact and trauma from a blunt object. Defense expert Peter Ross discovered two bullet fragments found near Laniet's bed had a number of what appeared to be white cotton fibers sticking to them. One of those bullet fragments had what he described as a weave pattern impregnated in its surface. In addition, three bullet fragments retrieved from inside her skull had white fibers adhering to them. Ross thought it therefore possible that at least one of the bullets had been fired through a pillow or wad of material. Police found nothing in the room to support the theory. The evidence wasn't necessarily helpful to the defense. David was the only one who left the house that morning, so perhaps he had taken the object with him and disposed of it. ESR scientist Kevin Walsh did not completely buy the Ross hypothesis regarding the white material. He examined the fibers and accepted one fragment, due to the weave pattern, appeared to have struck some type of woven garment or fabric. The white material found on the fragments contained calcium sulfate, found in many items including plaster wallboard, and some unidentified cellulose fibers, possibly from paper. He believed the white material had two different sources. It's a bit of a mystery. Either another shot has been fired that's fragmented outside or struck an object in the bedroom, possibly a wall. He couldn't rule out the white material adhering to the fragments being transferred from another object in subsequent handling.